51st competitive test. The action brought by the official receiver to test the validity of the bill of sale given to you by Mr. Smith, came on for trial today in the King's Bench Division of the High Court of Justice, before Mr. Justice Bright, regret to say that the learned judge, after hearing the arguments on both sides, decided against you on the ground that the document is not in accordance with the form prescribed by the Act of Parliament relating to bills of sales. You will remember that have many times pointed out to you that the Bills of Sale Act is so obscurely worded that great numbers of bills of sale prepared by the most eminent convincers have been set aside on the same ground. New para, it is open to you to carry the matter to the court of appeal, but I do not advise that course. Mr. Walter Morton's progress at the bar has been unusually rapid. He was called in 1947. Before he had been 2 years at the bar, he had been counsel for the plaintiff in an action for breach of promise of marriage, counsel for the defendant in an action in the probate, divorce, and admiralty division, I had appeared once in the ecclesiastical court, and once before the Lord Chancellor in a habeas corpus case, In every instance, he was successful, If he represented the plaintiff, the result was a verdict for the plaintiff, and if he represented the defendant, the result was a verdict for the defendant, New para, he is respected in the High Court of Justice for his thorough knowledge of the common law, and is always heard with marked attention in the divisional court, He argued with great ability a novel point raised on a commercial summons in the King's Bench last week, He has been retained in an improvement action on a bill of lading, and also in several assessment appeals arising out of the recent quinquennial valuation, He is an authority on the vexed question of employers' liability under the Workmen's Compensation Act, and is successful with a common jury as with the judge.